But essentially, when registering profiles, you need to register a profile through the IP of a real user, because nowadays we are dealing with social medias or like platforms that are super advanced, and they can spot when an IP is not legitimate IP. It's not in the sense of legitimate, but it's not a real IP from a real user, and they can flag or ban the profile directly from the very beginning.
Hey, what's up? This is Stan. We are here at Affiliate World Barcelona. And here with me, I have Martin, who is from Smartproxy. Smartproxy is actually our partner who provides really high quality, good proxy service. And today we're going to talk about proxies, IP addresses, and those things that are important for you to know regarding running your accounts without being detected and banned. What's up? How's it going?
Hey, how are you doing? It's all good. Enjoying Barcelona so far. So it's been a good experience so far.
Cool. So I know actually that Smartproxy is being utilized by a lot of affiliates, and also is being utilized by e-commerce entrepreneurs as well. What's the use case, and how do they use your proxy, and for which purposes?
So basically, in terms of multiple accounts, our clients are usually coming and they are asking, for example, to register and manage multiple accounts. It's not necessarily only limited to e-commerce. It could be, for example, Facebook accounts. It could be, for example, any social media type of account. So basically, how it works is that they are coming, and we need to recommend the tool. In most cases, that's a tool like multi-login. And how it works is that we are also knowledgeable in terms of the process. So we recommend the specific types of proxies that are needed for the process.
So I know when it comes to managing multiple like Facebook accounts, Google accounts, it boils down to having two really good solutions at place. The first one is being a really good proxy service, or having a really good quality IP address. And the second thing is actually having a solution like multi-login to mask the browser fingerprints and make browser fingerprints consistent with the data of the IP address. But like when we work with clients and they say their accounts get banned, like in 80% of all cases, what can be done to solve the problem, what can be done to cure the problem, is actually finding a really good proxy, a really good IP address. So I know that what kind of proxies Smartproxy provides, what kind of types Smartproxy can provide?
In general, we are a proxy provider, proxy technology provider, and we have residential proxy, data center proxy, dedicated data center IPs. And basically, we also have our own custom developed web scraping solution. So this is a topic that I'm not gonna cover now. Right. But in general, proxy wise, if we are speaking in the multiple account management sphere area, it's two main products that are used. And this is residential proxy and dedicated data center IPs. So to give you some context to elaborate a bit more, usually for account creation, for example, if the let's say a client is coming and they want to make 3,000 Twitter profiles. Right, so basically what we recommend is that for the creation of the accounts, the user is going to use residential proxy. Essentially, yes. Residential proxy is something that is IP from a device of the real person. So that gives the, for example, Twitter the credibility to trust this IP that a real person is creating the profile. So basically, if you want to create for example, thousands or hundreds of multiple accounts, social media accounts, right? You need to choose a residential proxy. Then when it comes to managing these accounts, we recommend dedicated data center proxies. So this product is basically data center proxies. You are given a list of IPs that is only dedicated to you. That is basically you're responsible for this list. And the client needs to dedicate a specific amount of IPs per specific account. So that's done, for example, if they rotate the proxy and they change the proxy quite often, then, for example, Twitter or whatever social media they've registered in, it's going to be spotted and the account will be flagged. After that, it's going to be banned. So that's why it's really important, for example, when clients are asking for the advice, just take the advice and use whatever tools are given to you and recommended to you by the provider, because we are not looking, for example, to sell something just for the sake of selling. We are looking to solve your problems and basically to recommend the best solution that is out there and that is suitable for your use case, right? Because we are dealing with clients like you every single day. So essentially, that's the two types, to summarize, the two types of proxies that are used in the multiple account management sphere industry is basically residential proxies and dedicated data center IPs.
That's very interesting what you said, that the scheme, or let's say the method that you propose to create create accounts using residential and then transfer them to a data center and when you are managing that account. Why do you think like any type of service is so sensitive on the registration part? And why is the service is okay when you're managing the profile using a data center? Because ultimately, managing your accounts on a data center IP is not always really bad. It's not bad. Why? It shouldn't be bad, because it also, normal users also sometimes manage their accounts on data center IPs. For example, like a VPN, or let's say they are connected to a private network. Like, why do you think the process works? Because I've also heard a lot of such methods from other users as well. So why do you think it works?
So this is a really, really broad topic that we are discussing internally as well with our product team. But essentially, when registering profiles, you need to register a profile through the IP of a real user, because nowadays we are dealing with social medias or like platforms that are super advanced, and they can spot when an IP is not legitimate IP. It's not in the sense of legitimate, but it's not a real IP from a real user. And they can flag or ban the profile directly from the very beginning. So that's why residential proxy is essential when you're creating the profile, because it gives the platform the credibility that you're a real person, that you're registering this profile from a real real account, you know,
home network.
A real IP. Yes, home network, essentially, yeah. Then, if we're speaking about managing the accounts, we have a product that is basically a static IP. It's dedicated data center IP, right? And you need to, when managing the account, you need to manage the account through the same or like a very small spectrum of IPs. Because if you log in through different IPs every time, then your profile is going to be banned. Essentially, what we do is that we recommend static IPs because our residential proxies are rotating.
Right.
It means that every time when you log into the profile to manage the account, you're gonna log in for another IP, for a different IP. Hence why the account will be banned, will be flagged and then banned.
Because the IP address, the residential IP addresses too often, and it might like trigger some warnings.
Absolutely, yes, absolutely right, yeah.
And because you've already created an account and you've passed the main verification points, which usually are on the registration part. Yeah, they don't usually employ a lot of detection mechanism or consistency checks when you're just like scrolling the feed, for example. It will be not wise to do that. That will overload the website. That is not a wise engineering decision. And like, I totally understand that. And it's very interesting like method, like to use this method, because many of our users are still using like data center IPs, and it works fine for them. But the idea to bypass like these checks in the beginning with a high quality IP address and then change to a data center is really, really, really freaking interesting.
Absolutely. So bear in mind that, for example, infrastructures like platforms like Google nowadays, they can even spot from the very beginning when the IP is coming from data center server, and they're just gonna block straight away.
Yeah.
So as you said, basically, just to repeat your words, yes, to bypass the security in the beginning, you would be asked to have a residential IP, like a real IP, you know. KYC processes are really tight nowadays. If you register an account with LinkedIn, they might even check to like make a screenshot of your ID, you know.
Yes, yes.
Super advanced. Yes. So you need to listen for how the knowledgeable people in the industry are doing it, listen to the advice, and basically there is no reason to repeat the mistakes that are already done.
True.
And to basically get the most from the knowledge that is already there.
Martin, thanks very much for sharing this really awesome method. Actually, this is a method that I've also thought about, and many users also told me about. If somebody is watching, I really suggest them to try, because this is a very logical way to go about, and it also feels a lot of, it kind of explains a lot when it comes to us trying to analyze user feedback. Thanks very much.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.